Session. Already we discussed about the basic definition of derivative and differentiation and some rules and standard formulas related to differentiation. Okay, rules to solve the problems and derivatives for some standard functions, all we learnt in the previous class, and now we are going to solve some simple examples based on those aspects. See, look at the board. Yeah, all these problems are based on this particular standard derivative. We know that d by dx of x power n is equals to n into x to the power n minus 1. So this d by dx of x power n is equals to n into x to the power n minus 1 is true for all the values of n. Based on that, we need to solve. Look at the problem 7. See, 7 is a constant, x is not involved there. So you may treat it like x power 0 or something. When you apply the same rule or by the basic definition for the constant function, the derivative is 0. Okay. Then d by dx of x power 1. You just use this one. N into x power n minus 1. So x to the power 1. So consider that n as 1. If you replace n with 1, 1 into x to the power 1 minus 1. Okay. And on simplification, its value is 1. Whereas d by dx of x square, so power is 2. So 2 into x to the power 2 minus 1 is equals to 2x. In the same way, if you wish to simplify anything, something like d by dx of x power 2020, what is its value? That power 2020 into x to the power 2020 minus 1, which is 2019. That's the value. Okay. And in the same way, we need to answer these questions. Okay. D by dx of 1 by x. So what is the value of d by dx of 1 by x? Just look here. We are going to find out the derivative for 1 by x. D by dx of 1 by x. To find out its derivative, you just rewrite this 1 by x as x to the power minus 1. We know that 1 by x as x power minus 1. Now, compare that x power minus 1 with this x power n. N is simply minus 1. So, its value is equals to minus 1 into x to the power minus 1 minus 1. And x to the power minus 1 minus 1 is minus 2. So, minus 1 into x to the power minus 2. On simplification, your answer is minus 1 by x square. So, finally at the end, d by dx of 1 by x is minus 1 by x square. Just look at the format, how we are generating that d by dx of 1 by x. In the same way, if you solve this problem, d by dx of 1 by x square, by rewriting, see, if it is d by dx of 1 by x square and this is d by dx of x power minus 2. So now in the next step, minus 2 into x to the power minus 2 minus 1. So, minus 2 into x to the power minus 3. Then it will become like minus 2 divided by x power 3. So, this answer is minus 2 by x cube. In the same way, since it is x power 3, then its answer is minus 3 by x power 4. So, while writing the derivatives of these functions, the behind logic is again simply this d by dx of x power n. And again, if you generalize this format, d by dx of 1 by x power n is equals to d by dx of 1 by x power n is equals to minus n divided by x to the power n plus 1. Okay, this is just a generalization for this format. And after this, we need to think about d by dx of root x. See, what is that root x? See, root, square root is simply power 1 by 2. So, to find out this d by dx of x power 1 by 2, again you need to rewrite that x power root x as x power 1 by 2. D by dx of x power 1 by 2. And since the power is 1 by 2, so you just apply this formula for n is equals to 1 by 2. So, this is equals to 1 by 2 into x to the power 1 by 2 minus 1. So, what to say about that 1 by 2 minus 1? This 1 by 2 minus 1 is simply minus 1 by 2. And x to the power minus 1 by 2 is what? 1 by root x. So, 1 by 2 into 1 by root x is 1 by 2 root x. So your answer for this particular problem, d by dx of root x is 1 by 2 root x. Okay. Then think about this. D by dx of 1 by root x. So 1 by root x. 1 by root x means x power minus 1 by 2. So minus 1 by 2 into x power minus 1 by 2 minus 1. See, this is equals to minus 1 by 2 into x power minus 1 by 2 minus 1 is minus 3 by 2. X power minus 3 by 2. See, since minus sign is there in the power, it comes to the denominator. So that is minus 1 by 2 into x power x root x. X power 3 by 2. So this answer is simply minus 1 by 2x root x. So these are also, see, helpful if you memorize this, okay? Not only this d by dx of x power n, if you memorize this format or as well formulas for this root x and 1 by root x directly, then it gives you some more confidence to solve the problem. Think about this d by dx of x power minus 6 by 5. Just replace n with minus 6 by 5, you will get your answer, okay? Just have a look. Here in this class, we are going to solve some simple problems based on the standard derivatives along with the rules which we discussed in the last class, like product rule, summation rule, as well chain rule, all these things, okay? Just have a look. So, see, here in this class we are solving some simple problems, okay? And now I have some simple problems based on sin x and x, which are based on the rules like summation rule, product rule, which we discussed in the last class. So the first thing is sin x plus cos x, simply sin x plus x. So our target is to find its derivative. So consider that d by dx of sin x plus x. Sin x plus x, and its derivative was d by dx of sin x plus x. D by dx of sin x plus x is d by dx of sin x plus d by dx of x. Okay? D by dx of sin x plus d by dx of x. And simply, d by dx of sin x is what? Cos x, whereas d by dx of x is 1. So, its derivative is cos x plus 1. We have a chance directly to say the derivative as cos x plus 1 because its derivative is cos x and its derivative is 1 just by sine, summation rule, okay? And now think about sin x into cos x. So here we need to calculate derivative for the product sin x into x. See, you may say sin x into x or x into sin x, no problem. But two functions, sin x is one function, x is another function, and there is a multiplication between them. Then in the sense we are going to use the product rule, which is simply nothing but sin x into derivative of x plus x into derivative of sin x. First function into the derivative of second function, as well second function into the derivative of first function. So that is equals to sin x into derivative of x is 1 plus x into derivative of sin x is cos x. At the end, your answer for the problem is sin x plus x cos x. That's it. Okay. And now another one is simply sin x by x. Here what? We need to use what? Quotient rule, right? So we discussed in the last class that quotient rule also. So d by dx of sin x by x. What is that quotient rule? As we discussed in the previous class, the quotient rule is simply nothing but, first of all, you need to write the square of denominator. See, x square. Then in the numerator, you just simply write denominator into derivative of numerator. So that in the sense, x into d by dx of sin x minus numerator into derivative of denominator sin x into d by dx of x. So this is equals to x into derivative of sin x is simply cos x minus derivative of x is 1 into sin x is sin x, and the whole thing is divided by x square. Just have a look. D by dx of sin x by x is x cos x minus sin x by x square. So this is what? Derivative of sin x plus x, and this is derivative of sin x into x, and this is derivative of sin x by x. Now, what to say about this derivative of this 3 sin x minus 4 cos x? So just it is again simply same as summation rule. but I just multiplied here with constant. As we discussed in the last class, constant multiplication. By that, this is simply 3 into d by dx of sin x minus 4 into d by dx of x. So 3 into d by dx of sin x is what? Cos x minus 4 into 1. So its answer is 3 cos x minus 4 into 1. That's it. Okay? Have a look. Just look at the problem. In the same way, if you have the function cos x plus e power x plus root x, what is its derivative? See, just as we discussed in 11a, sum of two functions, here it is the sum of three functions. And to apply the derivative, you will get it as d by dx of cos x plus d by dx of e power x plus d by dx of root x, just by summation rule. Simply you split your derivative on the sum. So its answer is derivative of cos x is what? See, this is equals to derivative of cos x is simply minus sin x, and derivative of e power x is e power x. We learnt from standard derivatives. Whereas the derivative of root x is simply 1 by 2 root x, which we observed in 10th point. Have a look at the end. The derivative for the sum cos x plus e power x plus root x is this minus sin x plus e power x plus 2 root x. And after that, what to say about the derivative of this product? For a product, we need to use product rule, but here the product of three functions is involved. See, product of three functions, simply to find its answer is simply nothing but derivative of the first function d by dx of cos x into second function into third function plus first function cos x into d by dx of second function e power x into third function plus first function cos x into e power x into d by dx of third function. Just have a look. This is the way of applying the product rule. Okay, derivative of first function, derivative of second function, as well derivative of the third function. Okay, see, while writing you must be careful, you must be careful in writing. Okay, and that is equals to d by dx of cos x is what? Minus sin x into second function e power x into third function root x plus cos x into derivative of e power x is e power x into root x plus cos x into, and the next thing is e power x into, derivative of root x is 1 by 2 root x. Now at the end, this is the answer for the product of three functions. After that, you just think about this cos of e power x. See, what is this cos of e power x? See, is there any summation involved? Is there any chance to apply product rule? So you just think about cos of e power x is not the product of cos and e power x. Involving e power x in the cos, it comes under what? G circle f, which is simply nothing but g of f of x. Indicates what? Chain rule, composition rule, composition of functions. So to answer the derivative for the composition functions, to answer these type of questions, we need to go with the chain rule, or you may say substitution rule. Already I mentioned the rule in the previous class. Now I am going to give you some simple problems based on that chain rule or solving composition of functions. Okay, have a look. Solving here in the sense finding derivative of the composite functions. Okay.